Hey guys, I'm not the best Hendrix player, but I give it a shot, okay? Yes for you, yes for you. So it's 1 year ago since I got this amazing guitar, and I thought I would do like a revisit. So my previous solar video was comparing the A1 to the A2. And if you haven't checked that out, I would recommend you to do that. If you're interested in knowing what is the difference. But today we're gonna talk about the A2-6, and this color is W. This is the white model, but they also have a carbon black, like matte black finish. And they also have a neon pink that just scream 80s Razor X for me. And also have a really yellow green kind of color they call lemon neon. And the A2 series is only $699. So let's read the spec sheet and see what it got. It got 24 frets, super jumbo, really comfortable to play. The radius is 350 millimeters, and that ends up to 13.78 inch, and that radius is super comfortable. It rounds just perfectly. The pickups are Duncan Solars, so it's something special for this guitar, and it's not just a Duncan designed or EMG designed kind of pickup you can see in those cheaper guitars. It's medium output. It's really good to have as a metal player, as it's a passive pickup and it doesn't overcompress instantly, so you can add your own overdrive or whatever. So we have Duncan Solars in both bridge and neck, and it's a five-way switch, so you can actually split, so you can use one pull piece from the humbucker, making it a single coil, and that's really useful on the neck. Tip. It's a mahogany body with a maple neck, and the fretboard is ebony, and I think it's a graphite nut. They have a tone knob, a volume knob, and they have tuners, 18:1 ratio, but they're not locking tuners. And it's actually set neck. It's the maple neck going into the body about here, and that makes a really solid connection. And this cutaway makes it really easy to be up in high frets and solo. So what is my thoughts of this guitar 1 year later? I've been playing this guitar and its brother, the Solar A16 ETC. I've been playing these non-stop since I got them. The Ibanezes and LTD I got, they've been put to shame. I love those guitars as well, but there's always like something with them that makes you not want to play them. Like some of the LTDs they have, but the neck radius is so flat, and that makes it really uncomfortable to play, as this one is a little bit rounder when it comes down here when it's solo, and that makes it so much more appealing. And when you pick it up, boom, there you got it. You can kind of feel that this is like a signature guitar. It's like Ola Englund's signature guitar, but it made it super affordable. I'm not gonna say cheap, because it's not cheap in any way. It's not cheap in, like, it's built cheap. No, it's built exactly like its brothers in the A1 series, but it's just that it, maybe some cheaper woods, maybe no locking tuners, maybe no Evertune. I really miss the Evertune, but still. The 2 series is not to be shamed in any way. It's really nice to have contrasting guitars. I have one white and one black. And it both do different things. The other one is alder body, and this is mahogany. Mahogany is more darker, but it also has more sustain than the alder. The alder is more brighter and in your face, kinda. You have to dial it EQ-wise a little different. And having a hard tail like this bolted to the body really hard, and then I also have the strings going through to the back, it really gives some sustain, you know? So nice to have this option for those who doesn't have the money to buy like $1,000 guitar or whatever. This one is a little bit cheaper, but you won't be too cheaped out from it. So let's say you wanted to have the pink one and you really love Floyd Rose. Yeah, you can get a Floyd Rose on it, and it's, I think that model is $100 US more. And then you get a Floyd Rose with a locking nut. Then the tuning will be so stable that this guitar is gonna play forever. And it won't really work against its brothers if you're in that kind of price range. And that's so useful. Also, a nice thing with the Solars generally is that they have the matte finish. And that makes the necks feel so smooth. You don't stick anywhere because of a glossy neck. It's so nice to sit down with your guitar after a nice summer day at the beach, sweating. It's so hot outside and your guitar neck is ice cold. That's something cool. And because this is a 1 year later video, I wanted to bring some cons that I found during the way. And the first thing is ironically what I just said. This happens to every matte guitar in the world, it's not just Solar. So because I've been playing so much, the neck is actually getting a little bit glossy, but it's never so it gets stuck. It's just a fast kind of gloss. So I have that spot on the neck, and I also have a spot here because I always anchor my ring finger when playing. Like that, but it's nothing that chips, it's nothing like that, it's just that it gets a little bit polished over here. Who cares? My second con is actually all Solars as well. It's because there is no string tree on this guitar. You have some ringing harmonics. Happening up there. And that can be really annoying when you're recording something with high gain. It can be like da 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 ding 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 ding. Like a high-pitched harmonic, just annoying you to death. So what people do is that they get string dampeners above the nut, and that helps. And on this guitar, I really, really, really miss my Evertune. If there's nothing really stopping it, the tuning can be a little wonky at times. And that's why I've been playing the Evertune more. That's the only reason. Then you just pick it up, boom, ready to play. This one you actually had to tune before. But it stays in pretty good tune. So guys, this was all for me today. I really, really, really love my Solar guitar. It's so good. For the price, it's too good. I just wanna thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna play you out this time with some nice coil split from the neck pickup. So, see you guys. Thank you guys for watching.